Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this particular video, I'm going to show you how to display your lyrics, your hymn in lower third format on vMix using just Notepad. So you'll be able to change, make the changes, do anything you want to do with it. Display your favorite lyrics, the hymn to your church, or anything you want to display, but your song in lower third format using just Notepad on vMix. In case you love videos like this or just coming across the channel for the first time, just hit that red subscribe button below. Also turn on the notification bell so you always be notified whenever I drop new videos here on my YouTube channel. And thank you once again for the 3,000 family members here on my YouTube channel. Thanks to all of you that have subscribed to my YouTube channel. And if you're a returning subscriber, remember to give this video a thumbs up so that other people can also benefit from the educative tutorial we're sharing here on my YouTube channel. Now, without any further ado, let's get straight to this particular tutorial. Remember, not making use of any third-party software for this particular tutorial. I'll be doing this strictly using vMix and also a Notepad, and it will look very nice. And this is the part where it gets very technical. I want you to watch every part of this particular section of the video so that you'll be able to get all the information on the tutorial I'm about to share with you now. If you miss any part, you might not get it right, okay? So now let me show you how to bring in your lyrics, your hymn, your song in lower third format on vMix also, okay? The first thing you're going to do is to just search for any lyrics of the song, or you want to bring in a lower third format on vMix. I'm just going to search for Ebo by Ada lyrics. Okay, this is this one of the song, and I want to bring this song in lower third format, the lyrics in lower third format on vMix. Let me just copy it. The first thing you're going to do, just to copy it, it's actually very easy. Just copy the lyrics of the song. Copy the lyrics. Okay, so copy this. And then when you're done copying it, I'm just going to copy from here to here. Don't want to copy everything, so just copy from here to here. Okay, from here to here, and go over to your PC and open Notepad. Okay, so open Notepad on your PC. Open Notepad on your PC and paste it there. And if you look very closely, it's currently scattered, so we are just going to arrange it in order. Okay, so we are going to arrange it in order. The first line. Okay, so we're going to stop here. After two lines, just add a break. We don't want everything jam-packed together. So after two lines, you add a break. Okay, so after another two lines again, you add another break. And then after two lines, you add another break. After two lines, we don't want everything looking scattered, okay? So we don't want it like that. We want everything to look nice, okay? So after two lines, add another break. After two lines, you add another break. Okay, you can see how everything is now. Okay, so once you're done adding all this, let me just close, minimize this and expand our Notepad. Okay, so remember, add quotation mark at the beginning, okay, and add the another quotation mark at the end of your space. Okay, so at the end of the first stanza which you added, okay, so on the second one, add another quotation mark beginning, and then here also add another quotation mark as well. So I'm just going to see if I can do it in a way that you can see it clearly. Oh, let me just expand this. I think you can see it like this. Okay, so add another quotation mark here also, and another quotation mark here as well, or another quotation mark at the beginning of new stanza, and another quotation mark at the end of the stanza. Okay, another quotation mark here. Remember, don't jam pack everything together. It will be looking rough on vMix. Okay, so want people to sing along and see all the lyrics boldly. Okay, so add another quotation mark here, another quotation mark at the beginning of another stanza, and at the end of the stanza, another quotation mark at the beginning of this one, and also at the end of this one, and another quotation mark at the beginning of this one also, and another quotation mark at the end of this one. Just keep doing that, keep doing that, and also at the end, add another quotation mark here. And you can see, once you are done adding this, go ahead and save it. See, save as, unless you're going to, you can create a document and put it in so that it will be very easy for you to locate. You wouldn't want it scattered among your file. Let's create a folder here and name this folder vMix. Okay, vMix data files. Let's name it vMix data files. Open this, the folder, and let's name it Jesus by Ada. Okay, so we're just going to name this Jesus by Ada. Leave it as text file, and also the encoding, make sure on UTF-8, which is this one here, and once you're done, go ahead and save it. Okay, so save it, close this, go over to your file explorer here. I'm just going to expand my hair so you can see it. Go over to document, which is where we the directory where we saved it, and you're going to see the vMix data file right here. Open it and you see the Jesus by Ada here now. Okay, so the next thing you are going to do is to click on this drop down ribbon, this expand ribbon here. You can see it right there. So click on this expand ribbon here, expand this, and once you've expanded this, go over to view. Okay, so go over to view, and we're currently on view. Once you're on view, you can turn this on. Turn this on is very, very important. This file name extension, turn it on. Okay, so for those of you using Windows 7, you might not see it up here. Now, another way for you to view this file name extension, view to turn it on, is to go over to options. You can see the options right here. Click on the options, and once the option opens, go over to view and scroll down a little bit. You're going to see the hide extension file names type. It's the same both on Windows 7. You can see the hide extension file for known file types. So turn this off. Make sure it's off. Turn it off here. Click on apply and click on OK, and you can see it's already turned on here. And this is it. It's already showing the file name extension. Now let's rename this file name. Okay, so you're just going to rename it from text file to CSV. Okay, that's because we so that we can be able to see it on vMix. Okay, so now let's rename it from text to CSV. Don't worry, it won't look scattered, everything will still look nice. Once you rename this file, close it, go over to vMix, and you see the add input right here. So click on the add input here, and once it opens, go over to title and SAML and scroll down. Scroll down, keep scrolling down, keep scrolling down. You're going to see the song blank here. See the song blank here. So select anyone you want to make use of. See the song blank right there. Select whichever one you want to make use of. So I want to make use of this one. You see the song blue, which is the one I want to make use of. Okay, so and you can see it right there. You can see it right there. You can see that is it right there on the screen. Now, how do we bring in the lyrics, the CSV file we just renamed? Go once you're here, don't start typing anything, don't worry. Go over to data source. Okay, so click on the data source right here. So once you're on data source, click on manage, click on manage, and you see the add button there, the plus sign there. Let me delete this one. Okay, so click on this plus sign here. You see the plus sign, click on it and select Excel and CSV, not the Google Sheets or the RSX, the text, the SML, don't import any of it. Click on the Excel and CSV. Okay, so click on it and let's rename it Jesus by Ada lyrics, which is what we're going to name it, Jesus by Ada lyrics, and click on the browse button here to bring in the file. Okay, so once you're here, go over to your document where you save the directory. You see the vMix data files here where you saved it. Open it and you're going to see the Jesus by Ada.csv. Click on it and open. Remember, don't turn any of this on. The convert row to columns, don't turn any of it on. Just leave it as like that. Click on OK, and you can see our lyrics here arranged properly for us. You can see everything is arranged properly for us. And once you get to this page, just once you've imported it, don't click on any other thing, don't expand anything. Just close this and click on this data source here that is none, and you're going to see the Jesus by Ada lyrics that we just brought in. Okay, and once you select it on the column, select column one, don't leave it as auto, select column one, and leave the table as sheet one, and leave the row as selected. Leave everything the way it is, just the column tab, select column one, and leave every other thing the way they are. Okay, so once you're done, click on OK, and you can see it right there on the screen. Now let's expand this, let's expand this, expand this, expand this, expand this, and click on the data source again. Click on manage. Once you open the manage tab, this one, you can close every other tab. Okay, so you don't need any other tab again. Put it on the screen like four and open the data source manage tab here that we just can see it here. This is it. Let me just resize this so you can see it clearly. You can see it here. So whatever changes you are making here, you see it's reflecting on vMix. You can see our song is reflecting on vMix. As they're singing it, they are also reflecting on vMix. So the lyrics to the song, and people can also sing along as well. You can see they can sing along as well. They can sing along as well as they're singing it. They are going back to the first one, and you can see. So this is how to bring your lyrics to vMix, your hymn or whichever one you want to. This is how to bring it in on vMix. And if you don't understand anything, just comment in the comment section below, or you can also send me a message on WhatsApp and let's get it done as well. I'm everly ready to assist you in whichever way I can. Okay, so and this is it. You can see all everything is changing. So if you finish the first line, you go back to the next one. If you finish this one, you go back to the next one. Okay, see, what can't you do, Jesus? Okay, Jesus, creator of the universe, what can't you do? What can't you do, Jesus? Somebody say, name above every other name. See, you can also sing along to it. So if you love this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel and also give this video a thumbs up so other people on YouTube can also see the educative tutorial we're sharing on this my YouTube channel. And if you haven't subscribed, hit that red subscribe button below and also turn on the notification bell so you always be notified whenever I drop new videos.